Good morning, students. In the previous video, I had explained how the deoxygenated blood enters the heart and the oxygenated blood moves out of the heart. So here is a schematic diagram of the circulation. The capillaries, as you all can see, that the capillaries are thin tubes. It takes all the deoxygenated blood from all the parts of the body. It transfers it to the veins. From the vein, it goes to the heart. And from the heart, if you remember, it goes to the right atrium, to the right ventricle, and then to the pulmonary artery. And from the pulmonary artery, it goes to the lungs. And in the lungs, when the lungs receive oxygen, the blood becomes oxygenated. Okay, then the oxygenated blood is transferred from the lungs to the pulmonary veins. Okay, from the pulmonary veins, it goes to the heart, then to the left atrium, then to the left ventricle, and then from the aorta, it moves to all the arteries. Okay, it is oxygenated blood is given to arteries, and then these arteries are again connected to the capillaries, and it moves to all the parts of the body. Okay, so this is how the circulation takes place in our body, the deoxygenated blood and the oxygenated blood. Clear? Now here there is a question given. Okay, that see the paheli and bujho. Bujho is saying, I am confused. I have learned that an artery always carries oxygen rich blood. Okay, children, I have already told you that arteries always carry oxygen rich blood. But in the previous video, I explained that pulmonary artery is an exception, isn't it? Bujho is asking that why, since the artery is carry, all the arteries carry oxygen rich blood, then why pulmonary artery is called an artery and not a vein? Okay, that means that pulmonary artery, I told you that pulmonary artery is carrying which kind of blood? Pulmonary artery, all the arteries carry oxygen rich blood except for the pulmonary artery, isn't it? The pulmonary artery carries which blood? It carries deoxygenated blood. Okay, the pulmonary artery carries deoxygenated blood. So he is asking why still it is called an artery and not a vein, because since it is carrying deoxygenated blood, so it should be called a vein. So what is the reason? Paheli is explaining that pulmonary artery carries blood from the heart, so that is why it is called an artery. If you remember, children, in my first video, I had told you that arteries carry oxygen blood rich from the heart to all the parts of the body. Okay, so that is why here also it is pulmonary artery. If you can see in the figure, it is carrying the blood, even though it is carrying deoxygenated blood. This pulmonary artery is carrying deoxygenated blood, but it is carrying blood from the heart. So that is why it is called a artery and not a vein. Okay, so this question can come in the exam. Why pulmonary artery, even though pulmonary artery carries deoxygenated blood, why it is called an artery and not a vein? Okay, so that is the reason, because it is carrying blood from the artery. Okay, then we come to the next topic, that is the blood donation. Blood donation, you all must have heard about blood donation, children, isn't it? See, there are many people who die due to unavailability of blood. Okay, so voluntary blood donation should be done. That means you all are small children, so you all cannot go for blood donation, but the adults or the big ones or your father or your mother, they can very well go for blood donation. Okay, blood donation is painless and it is harmless. Many people think that if we donate the blood, that much amount, for example, if you take 1 liter, 1 bottle of blood, okay? So many people think that if we donate 1 bottle of blood, our body will be short of blood, okay? So there is no need to worry about that. Blood donation is harmless and it is painless also. And remember, children, whenever you donate blood, even if you are donating 1 bottle of blood, usually when you go for blood donation, only one bottle of blood is taken, okay? So when you are donating blood, within 24 hours, your body will remake that much amount of blood. You have given 1 bottle of blood, within 24 hours, that much blood will be made by your body. So there is no need to worry for blood donation, okay? And nowadays there are blood banks, are special care blood banks are there where donated bloods can be stored with special care. So blood donation is a very easy process. It is a harmless process and painless process, and so we should go for blood donation so that we can save many precious lives. Okay, clear? Then, in the previous video, I had explained about the sections of the heart. Okay. Now, when I was explaining the sections of the heart, I had left one part, that is the septum. Okay. The septum is not given in your book, but you should know about this septum. What is septum? See, children, you all have seen that the blood enters into the heart and it comes to the right atrium, right ventricle. See, deoxygenated blood is entering from here, okay, going to pulmonary arteries and then getting oxygenated, and then see, oxygenated blood is again entering from here. So what will happen if the oxygen rich blood and the carbon dioxide rich blood will mix with each other? Okay, so what will happen if it mixes? Nothing can be done. So for that reason only, see, you have got a wall here, okay, and this wall is called as the septum. It is, you can see there is a partition in between, okay? So here you have the deoxygenated blood and here you have the oxygenated blood, and it is divided by a thin wall, and this wall is called as the septum, okay? So septum does not allow the oxygenated blood and the deoxygenated blood to mix with each other. So our body, in the heart, the oxygenated blood and the deoxygenated blood remains separate because of this thin wall, which is called as the septum. Okay, clear? One more question is given here. Paheli wonders which side of the heart will have oxygen rich blood and which side will have carbon dioxide rich blood. I have explained it to you already, children. So this answer you will write on your own. Okay. I hope you will be able to write it on your own because I have already explained it in my video. The next topic we will do in our next class. Thank you, children.